The gifts of God are not for personal use and entertainment. As I said last Sunday, there is a lot of showmanship using the gifts. And that's not the purpose. You must ask yourself, after I have told you your ID number and your phone number and your grandmother's name, what has it done to build you up? I admit, as church leadership, we have abused them. We've used them for our personal gain. Today we sell our prayers. You want to have time of me praying for you? Phone this number. We have become these superstars who are extremely gifted. Nobody can touch us except through buying your way. That's why we will attack that so that we get the real deal. Every gift that operates, it must build me up. Every gift that operates, it must build you up in your spirit, man. Amen.
Hallelujah.
It's not showmanship. And it's amazing why Paul, how Paul, every time he wrote to a church teaching about gifts, it was to correct the abuse of the gifts. Just like we experience it in our day, where people are using gifts to show off. Paul was writing letters to the churches to correct that error. Amen.
Hallelujah.
So wherever you are, if the gift is not used to honor God and build you up, get away from that. It's nothing but showmanship. So practical, how do we operate in the gifts? Number one, find a local church. Submit to that local church. Commit yourself to that local church. And be accountable to that local church. And then you can use your gifts there to build each other up spiritually. You cannot operate as a fly by night. You know, when we came to Christ, this was the biggest danger in the church, where everybody wanted to have a tent and miss the point. I'll show you in scripture. Now,
please bring yours. The one that is causing you to be angry right now, I will show you mine. I haven't found a scripture that
Christ
is contrary.
Established a local church.
Christ was a key band.